Life goes on day after day.
My name's Mark Kenny.
And what are you doing here tonight?
I'm here for the Liverpool legends, like everybody else.
Which is?
Bruce Scrobbelaar, Teddy McDermott and Phil Thompson.
And why are they here?
They're here because we're in Liverpool, got a massive fan base, and people want to meet the heroes. It's been running about a year now. I think this is about the sixth show. It was Nick Tanner, ex-Liverpool player, ex-defender. He was there through the Kenny. He got signed by Kenny Dalglish, and then he went through the Souness period. So he, you know, some of the team that he played in was frightening. You know, you got Barnes, Mulby, Grobbelaar, Rush, Whelan. Oh, there's countless players.
I believe you're going on stage in a couple of minutes.
Yep, going on a couple of minutes.
What are you going to open up with?
Obviously my song. What's it like in Liverpool?
Okay, and how's that doing as a job?
It's doing very well. It's been picked up by a US TV documentary called Liverpool to the USA, which I'm sure you've watched it. It's signed to Cavern Records. It's been picked up by Liverpool Tourism. So it's been used to promote Liverpool all over the globe. And it's done really, really well. I'm really proud of it. Of course, I'll be singing Never Walk Alone as well.
You know I wish you were here. It's not yet been a month, I know, but it feels a year. And I can write a letter, probably do that too. And now I'll write a song, I sing it just to you. Oh, yo, what's it like in Liverpool? Though I'd have the world away, you know that I'll be coming home to you. Can you raise a smile? Can you make it all worthwhile without you? I don't know what I would do, but I'll be yours soon. Oh, yo, oh, yo, oh, yo, oh, yo. When you go to sleep, close your eyes and dream a dream. There's nowhere that the mind can't reach, nothing that the eye can see. Liverpool will soon be there. We will dance without a care. For that I know we must go. The city waits for you. Oh, the old, what's it like in Liverpool? Although I'm half the world away, you know that I'll be coming home to you. Can you raise a smile? Can you make it all worthwhile without you? I don't know what I would do, but I'll be yours soon. Oh, yo, oh, yo, oh, yo, oh, yo. What's it like in Liverpool? Oh, yo.
So I believe this evening the charity of choice by the Liverpool legends is Charlie's Chance. Can you tell me about that?
He's a young lad.
He came here two or three times, if I remember rightly. And he had to travel abroad to get the work done, and now they're trying to raise money for other kids in similar sort of positions.
Fantastic,
you know what I mean?
Charity.
Yeah. Anything to do with kids is boss, do you know what I mean? Help any of them.
So is there any particular prizes that you can mention?
Yeah, there's a couple of signed shirts. Quite a few people have donated. We've got a signed DVD. We've got a really nice bottle of whiskey. You know, so there's a mixture of all sorts. So some really good prizes, and some local shops have given prizes as well. So it's fantastic.
Good evening again. Your name is?
Hello, Phil. I'm Dave Kirby. Mad Red. So did you just happen to be two tonight? And they're from Kirby, by the way.
Obviously.
Phil Thompson.
Right.
Teddy McDermott. Two Kirby lads.
Do you know these from Kirby?
Yeah, I know Phil. I know, remember Phil. He's from at least a bevy in the Falcon in Kirby. The Falcon was a legendary ale house back in the day. And Phil was there was one special night after we won the cup in 1981 in Paris, the European Cup, by the way, not the little crappy little FA Cup. I'm talking about the European Cup here. And Phil brought the European Cup back into the Falcon. We were in the there's a boozer called the Kingfisher down in Kirby. We were all in there. We just got back from Paris after 2 days. We were all wiped out completely. Anyway, there was no internet or phones then. These kids on the door said, the European Cup's in the Falcon. So we're on the Kingy, which is about half a mile away. We went, nah, no, I'm not having that. So we sent this kid up, we give him a pound note, and this kid ran up to the Falcon. He runs back about 20 minutes later. He runs in like a Rottweiler's just been chasing him. He's like, that, it's in there. So anyway, it was like a stampede out of the Kingfisher. It's about 30 lads, and we all ran up Beauty's Drive in Kirby. We got to the Falcon in Kirby, and there, I mean, we couldn't get in. There was taxis pulling up from all places in Kirby. Next thing, there's lads all I know running around, and they're off the windows, and they're like dropping the kecks and putting a bare ass on the window and all that, showing us the European Cup. They were all running around, we couldn't get in. But Phil Thompson brought the European Cup back to the Falcon in Kirby. How unique is that? And he still is, by the way. He's a great lad. He's in here now. He's signing all sorts, and he's like, he's our school, do you know what I mean? He's proper. Yeah, well, I've got this Everton programme. Liverpool, when we beat Everton at Main Road. Fuck. That was sweet, that. 77. That's the game we all started singing, we're on our way to Roma on the 25th of May. All the carpets will be singing, Vatican bells, they will be. That was the game it all kicked off. The final in Rome, 77. And Grobbel has a testimonial. So they're the three in there. Like. It doesn't matter how old you are. I'm nearer 60 now than 50. But I'm still like a bit of a kid when I see these fellas. Because, I mean, in back in the day when I was working in the building trade and all that, I'm fortunate now. I'm a playwright now and all that, carry on. But back in the day when I was working in the building trade, no, I'd go to work all week and it was a horrible job. I hated my job and all that. Like everyone, most people hate their jobs. But at the end of that week, mate, that football club was what made me escape. And like, you know, they gave me some fantastic times, and especially through the tatty years and all that carry on. I was going to unemployment matches and all that, you know, picket lines, all that. But at the end of the week, Liverpool Football Club, they took me to a different place. And these are the lads who's done it, do you know what I mean? So at the end of the day, you know, there's always reverence to these lads here, and eternal reverence, because these are legends, proper legends, and Kirby legends as well.
Yeah, not too bad, thanks, yeah. Tap me on the shoulder. Hello, mate.
Best chapter in the book.
Is it the best chapter in the book? Bloody hell. I haven't seen it for a long time. Oh. Best chapter. Oh, I'll sign it for you then. Is it the best chapter in the book?
Yes, it is. Yes, great. Thanks.
I've got rid of the Y off the Nicky.
Thanks very much.
Thanks for that. Thanks, Dad.
Life goes on day after day. Each with their own secret care. And so fairly fast as he, and it all, we sit there, the place I love. You are all safe. Here I stay.
How's it going, guys? We're having a great time here. It's fantastic.
It's love to last forever. It's love that has no past.
Come on, Brucey.
But don't let me down. But don't let me down. First time that she really done me. She done me. She done me good. I guess. guess nobody ever really done me, she done me good.
Same old jokes, isn't it? Jim, you're going like, oh, I've heard them a million times. Yeah, come on. Oh, yeah, you all right?
Sound.
Yeah, which one?
That.
Which one?
Yeah.
Keep it. Pull it tight.
You all right?
Pull it tight.
And who's this?
I think it's Claire, isn't it? Who won the competition at Radio City?
Yeah.
Yeah. What did you win, Claire?
I won 2 tickets for tonight, VIP tickets, meet and greet.
I'm sure I'm the lady in the middle.
Oh,
I'm the lady. Yeah.
Fantastic.
Oh, we've been to a few of these sportsmen's dinners with all Liverpool players, yeah. It's always great to hear the old, you know, stories about the old times. Like,
we're going to bring as much of the Anfield atmosphere to you guys as we possibly can now. So just before we start, can I have a massive shout for our flag wavers, please? Well done, guys. We're fortunate we're in a room high enough as well to get them.
We were through the storm. Hold your head high and don't be afraid of the dark. At the end of the storm, there's a goal. The sky and a sweet silver song of love. Oh,
and you never
pleasure to welcome to the stage, first up, the voice of Anfield, the legend, is Mr. George Sefton.
The one bad side of when I eventually came round in the Royal was I looked in a mirror and there was a sign across my forehead saying, "Do not resuscitate." That was fine, except it was in my wife's handwriting. Started out standing on the cop watching the Reds and ended up living everybody's dream. Achieved all sorts with Liverpool. A great player. A proper run through a brick wall, shanty type player. Mr. Phil Thompson. Every crowd. This is why I like going on earlier when you're still reasonably sober. Do you think Carius is the answer to our prayers?
Well, listen, if you go on the YouTube and on his previous season in the Bundesliga, you'll find that he ended up second to Neuer in the Bundesliga. And if you go and have a look at his highlights in the Bundesliga, I looked at them and I thought, well, this youngster looks very similar to what I did when I first came here.
Oh, no.
Yeah. So if he can carry on and, if he can stay in at the first team, in the first team for a couple of seasons, he could go on to stay there for a very long time.
When I was with Gerard Houllier, we went to Highbury, and it was lovely. Highbury, fantastic. It was an old... It was an old English ground, four huge stands, open in the corners. It was a fantastic stadium. And if you think about it, just paint the picture. When me and Houllier used to come out the dugout, we would sit on the left-hand side. You know the glass dugouts that they had there at Highbury? Fantastic. So to me and Gerard sit on the left, 38,000 in the stadium. Arsene Wenger and Pat Rice, then as assistant, would be sitting on the right. To the right of them was the paddock. Remember where Jamie Carragher threw a pound coin?
Yeah.
And hit 500 Arsenal fans all want compensation, greedy bastards.
The joys of being geriatric is I'm old enough to remember your entire career and this lad and this girl. Well, you signed apprentice forms about 3 months before I started working at the club.
Yeah. Right?
And I must tell you, ladies and gentlemen, I've said this before and I'll say it again. I used to go into work on a Monday morning raving about this skinny kid in the reserves. Said he's going to be great, he's going to be great. And he was, wasn't he? Wasn't he fantastic?
You must be the only fella to walk into a wall with a hard on so break your fucking nose. But you used to have to stand on and go, yes, boss, yes, boss.
I was at Newcastle. I loved it there. Loved being there. Great club, great people. Still live up there now. And one day I got a call. My dream was to play for Liverpool from Kirby. Just went to every game. St. John, Hunty was my favourites. And then all of a sudden I got a call off someone who sat on this stage, actually, it was. One day he just said, "Do you fancy coming to Liverpool?" Now I'm thinking, is he winding me up? Obviously it was travel, wasn't it? And it was illegal, by the way. I could get him done for that.
Off you go, Bruce.
Oh, he didn't know he was saying anything.
No, but listen, My first experience with coming to Anfield was Bob Paisley coming out to Vancouver, because he didn't think that I was, he didn't know where I was. He thought I was in Crewe. when they said, well, he's from Vancouver, he had to get in on the plane and fly to Vancouver with Tom Saunders. And after a game one night, we had lost the game in a penalty, it was a shootout, where they take the ball 35 yards and beat the keeper. And we had lost this to San Diego Soccer. And I'm sitting in the bath, and my manager says to me, listen, there's two very important people coming to see you. And so I said, okay. Got dressed quickly, went into the office, and I was introduced to Tom Saunders. Hello, Mr. Saunders. Hello, Mr. Paisley. And then the manager said, well, he'd like to ask you a few questions. Well, he only asked me one. He said, yeah.
Go on.
Grobbledy Jack. he couldn't say my name. He said, would you like to play for Liverpool? So I said, yes, Mr. Paisley, I'd love to play for Liverpool. He said, yeah, okay, go on, let's go. And they bugged out through the door, and I never saw them for 6 weeks.
I'm also writing my own book. It's about the I came from grassroots football. I used to support football teams. It's a terrible plug, but it's called From Afield to Anfield, and it'll be out next year, and it's about my journey from non-league football to Anfield, hence Mayfield to Anfield.